Hello, YouTube Gamer Dad here. This is video number 15 in our 2D space shooter tutorial series in XNA. The last video I mentioned in the second part of our collision videos there, that there's a couple of different ways I could have went with this tutorial from here. I know I mentioned like a sprite class, I mentioned, you know, a font class, but I think since we're still kind of early in the tutorial series, I'm just going to stick to the basics, and we're going to work on a health bar this video, okay? It's pretty simple. We're going to be handling most of it in our player class because obviously we're going to be updating the player health, so we might as well handle that in the player class. All right, and with that, we'll get started. So hop on in. Actually, there's one thing I want to fix beforehand. Remember how we were having issues with our asteroids, the collision boxes on them, how if you went to the left side of the asteroid, the bullets would go right through. I made a comment in the comments section of my last video and mentioned that when the sprite's rotating, it's also rotating the x-axis on the sprite so that the bounding box is like getting all wacky and trying to follow that, and it's not staying on the asteroid. So what we're going to do for the time being is go into our asteroid class, and we're just going to comment out all this rotation code. I looked at some examples on how to resolve this, how to get the bounding box to follow the rotation of the asteroid, and it's a lot of math. As you guys know by now, I'm not a big fan of math. I know I love the program, but I hate math. That doesn't really go together. But so go ahead into your asteroid class, comment out your asteroid code, comment out the origins here. We're in our update function of our asteroid class, and then we can change the draw down here too. It'll just be a texture, which is our texture, our position, and then color.white. Okay, just so we don't mess with any of this, messing with any of this rotation code right now, because our bounding boxes are off and we're not going to get accurate hits for the time being if we're doing that. So let's save this and build it. Play, and our asteroid should come down without rotating now. See how they're just static, but at least our collision is good. See, you can even go to the left side of the asteroid and it's hitting it. We're not having our bullets going through the asteroids or anything like that, and it's going to work better with our ship too. It's going to collide a lot nicer. Okay, so we'll leave them like we'll leave the asteroids like that for now, and then let's get into drawing our health bar. So first, we're going to go into our player.cs. We're going to add a few variables. We're going to add a texture 2D. Which we're just going to call health texture. Okay, we're going to add another int, another integer variable. We'll call that health, and we're going to add another rectangle. So we can go here, and it's going to be called health rectangle. Okay. I updated the zip file, and I use Dropbox, so it'll be updated. The link will update in all the videos automatically. It'll bring you to the same zip file. I added our health texture to it, so might as well go in here now. You're gonna have to go and re-download the zip file from any of the videos in my tutorial, including this one. So right-click your content. After you download that zip file, go ahead and add an existing item. Navigate to your folder with our graphics in it and just select health bar. All this is a 25 by 25 pixel red box. That's it. Okay, go ahead and add that. I just called it health bar. Okay, now that we have our health bar PNG added and we added our variables up here, we can set some of the variables in here. We're just going to set health equal to 200. Reason being is because the way this works, if I would have set health to 100 like you would normally think you would, we're using this health variable kind of as the width for our health rectangle. So 100 pixels isn't very big. So what we can do instead is just create it at 200. And then every time an asteroid hits, let's say you want it to take 10%, you would just plus or negative or equal to 20. So it'd take 10 asteroid hits before your ship died. Okay? But this is basically just making our health bar longer because it's 200 pixels wide now instead of 100 pixels. All right? And you'll see how that all works in a minute. Okay, so we set our health. We want to go down here and set in our load content of our player class. We want to set our health texture equals content.load texture2D. And we loaded the content already, and it's called health bar. Okay. Next, we go down to our draw function. And we're going to be wanting to draw our health bar, obviously, every frame, because we want it to update. So it'll be spritebatch.draw. And it's going to take a texture. We're going to draw our health texture. And then the position is going to be the health rectangle. And then just color.white. Not wheat, white. Okay, so, and we're going to be setting this health rectangle here in a minute. And basically, what this texture is going to do is it's going to draw it inside of our health rectangle for the length of our health rectangle, okay? So even though the PNG is 25 by 25, it's going to stretch it to fit this health rectangle, all right? Because it's just going to draw over that whole location there inside of our rectangle. It says color white here, but that doesn't matter because remember when I say that we put color white just by default, because any image is going to override that anyways, and it's a red health bar, so it'll show up red. Okay, so now that we added our draw to draw our health texture, we can go down to our update function, and this is we're going to see we have our bounding box for our player ship. We can just add underneath this and set our rectangle for, let's comment this, for health bar. Okay, and so it'll be health rectangle will equal a new rectangle. And just hit down here. So this, like every other rectangle we've done, this takes an X position, a Y position, a width, and a height. So, and you can put this anywhere. I mean, if you wanted to create some new variables up here, like health bar position. Actually, you know what? Let's do that. Let's create another vector 2 and call it health bar position. Okay. And then we can, in our constructor, we can set where we want that to be. So health bar position will equal to a new vector 2. And where do we want it on the X? Let's see, most health bars are in the top left corner of the screen, so I guess we could do that for now. And you guys can change this to wherever you need your health bar to be, okay? But I'm just going to say 50 pixels from the left and 50 pixels from the top. All right. So now we can go back down into our where we're setting our rectangle in our where are we at? In our update function. So we're setting the rectangle for our health bar. So health rectangle equals new rectangle. And this is going to take an X, a Y, a width, and a height. So we can say typecast as an int. We can say health bar position dot X. Cast this as an int, and health bar position dot y, and then it's going to take a width. I remember I mentioned that the health variable is holding the width of our is going to be holding the width of our rectangle, so we just put health here, and then the height that we want for our health bar, and I'm just going to say 25 because that's the height of our PNG anyways, okay. Alright, so let's go over this real quick. So we set some new variables. We set a new texture to hold our health texture in, which is just a 25 by 25 red box that will scale to our rectangle. We created a new vector 2 just now, and we just did this off the top of my head because it is helping, called health bar position. Okay, we set a new integer variable called health, which is basically just holding the pixels length for how long we want our health bar to be, okay? And then another rectangle called health rectangle. So our health texture is just going to fill that health rectangle. All right, we set our variables here. We went into our load content. We set our health texture to the PNG that we loaded. We went into our draw. We're going to draw our health texture at the health rectangle and just default color white. And then we're setting our health rectangle down here. And like I said, we're just setting it at a health bar position, which is you can above that new vector 2 that we set. You can put it, this is wherever you want your health bar to be on the screen, the X and the Y. And then it's taking a width and a height. And the width is just, like I said, the health variable, which we set at 200. So it's going to be 200 pixels long and 25 pixels high. Okay? And that's it. I mean, that's it. That's all for our health bar in our player class. And then all we need to do over in our game1.cs is tell it what to do when an asteroid hits the spaceship. So if we go to our update here, remember that simple thing we did in our collision video? With if the asteroid's bounding box is intersecting with the player bounding box, then we're going to set the asteroid to visible, so it's going to destroy the asteroid. And if that since that asteroid's hitting a spaceship, we want to have the spaceship take damage as well. So p.health is negative or equal to 20. So we'll just say 20. Since the health bar is 200 pixels wide, we're going to take 20 pixels off the end of that every time it gets hit. And then when it hits zero, it'll just be gone. There'll be no more health bar left, okay? And that's it. So if we save, build the solution, run, should see our health bar up in the top left corner. Okay, and every time an asteroid hits us, it's going to take 20 away from 200. Okay, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 20 health left. 10. Bam, we are dead. And I always do that. So, that's it. One thing I did in that the very first video in this series that I made, I did that little preview video on that Allegro game that I was working on. I want to kind of base this off of that. I made power-ups in that game. We're going to do the same for this, where we're going to have it randomly spawn like a double shot power-up or a health pack power-up. When you're killing the asteroids, it'll randomly decide when, a power-up will pop out. And then we'll have that, let's say the health power-up, we'll have that health power-up, restore a certain amount of our life or something like that. But that probably won't be for a few videos down the road. I want to get sounds incorporated in. I want to get sounds. Definitely the next videos are going to be our font videos, so we can get our score up on the screen and stuff like that. And then I'll decide from there. So this is a pretty easy tutorial, guys. Pretty cool way of setting health. If you have any questions, like usual, go ahead down in the comments and ask me or send me a message, which is what most of you guys have been doing, just sending me messages on YouTube. So until then, guys, join me next time. Next video, like I said, we'll be dealing with fonts and drawing them to the screen. All right, peace.